A new analysis from NPR this week confirmed what other analyses have confirmed over the last few months, and that is that if you live in a red county, a county that voted for Donald Trump in the 2020 election, your chances of dying from COVID or even catching COVID are at least 3 times higher than those who live in blue counties. And in fact, in many of the Trump counties, your chances of dying from COVID are 6 times higher than those living in Biden counties. 6 times higher for those living in red counties. And of course, the reason for that is because counties that voted for Trump are less likely to be vaccinated than counties that voted for Biden. And NPR went deeper into the data and they found that the larger the margin that Trump won by, the lower the number of vaccinated people, percentage-wise. So the more Trump voters you have, the fewer vaccinated individuals you have. It is a remarkable construct that is taking place here in the United States today. At this point, only 10% of registered Democrats are not vaccinated. Over 40% of Republicans are not vaccinated. And they're dying at a rate of 6 times those of the Democrats. So the reason I bring this up, because we have talked about this plenty of times, the NPR report only gave us a little bit new data, but here's the thing. We have midterm elections in less than a year now, and Republicans are poised to make really, really big gains. But I wonder if any of those polls, any of those predictions, any of that has actually factored in what's going to happen when 300,000 Republicans are dead. I mean, let's not kid ourselves. Let's not dance around the subject. Ooh, that's too dark. We don't want to talk about it. No, we do. We are looking at losing 400,000 to 500,000 Republicans off the voting rolls because they were too stupid to protect themselves from COVID. Now, I can't actually say too stupid. Plenty of these people died, left and right, before we had vaccines, before we had really viable treatments, which we're still searching for right now. So it's not fair to say they're all stupid. Sorry about that. But from this point forward, sure, we have protections in place. There are things you could do. We know that masks work. The data shows that. We know that the vaccines are effective. The data shows that. But if you're going around choosing to not do one of those things because of partisan political issues, and then you die of COVID, that is your fault. That's your fault. So what happens to the Republican Party when they have these hundreds of thousands of voters who aren't here this time next year? Now, I think we all know what happens. They're going to be shocked when they wake up the morning after Election Day to realize, oh my God, we didn't win as much as we thought we would. Now, of course, if Biden's approval rating keeps falling, if the Democrats don't deliver, they're still going to win, right? Don't get me wrong about that. But there is going to be this little X factor that's floating around out there, which is lots of Republicans are dying constantly. And if you think that's not going to have some kind of impact on the 2022 midterm elections, then you clearly don't know how elections work. If you kill off your base, there's nobody left to vote for you, which probably means you're not going to make it to office.